Hi, I'm Justin Bender, Portfolio Manager at PWL Capital in Toronto, and this is episode 2 of my Do-It-Yourself Investing Series. Today's lesson is on how to build an ETF portfolio at BMO Investorline. For example, we'll be purchasing the 5 ETFs for my 40% fixed income, 60% equity model portfolio. Please feel free to download the model portfolios from my blog before getting started. We'll begin by hovering over the trading tab at the top left of the screen and clicking on equities. After reviewing the account balance details, we find that there is $25,000 of cash available for investment within the Canadian dollar RSP account. The first 3 trading details will be the same for each of our ETFs. The type of trade will be equity, the action will be buy, and the market will be Canadian. Let's start by entering VCN as our symbol. Hitting the tab key will populate a quote for the ETF to the right. When we're buying an ETF, we'll be focusing on the ask price, which is the price per share that an investor is willing to sell the ETF to us for. To calculate the number of shares we need to purchase, we'll use our computer's calculator. Multiplying the total account value of $25,000 by VCN's target allocation at 20%, or 0.2, gives us $5,000. We then subtract the trading commission of $9.95 from this amount, and divide by the current ask price of the ETF, which is $28.53 in our example. This equals 174 shares. We can just round down to the nearest whole share. Let's go ahead and enter 174 in the quantity field. For the next step, I prefer to select price limit instead of at market, as this puts a cap on how much we are willing to pay for the ETF. In the price limit of field, enter in an amount that's a few cents higher than the current ask price. Even if you use a higher limit price to place your trade, you'll still receive the lower ask price if it's available. The settlement funds drop-down menu should be set to Canadian dollars, as we'll be using Canadian dollars to purchase our ETFs. The good until drop-down menu should be set to today only, meaning that if your trade does not get filled by the end of the trading day, it'll expire. Enter your phone number next, and click on the Remember This Contact Information checkbox, so that you won't have to enter it again during this trading session. Once you've reviewed the order details and verified that the estimated total order value is approximately the dollar amount that you'd like to purchase, enter your trading password. You can also click on the Remember My Trading Password checkbox so that you won't have to enter the password again during this trading session. When you're ready to send the trade request, click on Submit Order. And to place your next trade, click on Place Another Trade. For the next trade, we'll ensure that Equity, Buy, and Canadian are all selected. We'll enter VUN next as our symbol, and hit the tab key to populate a quote to the right. We'll multiply our total account value of $25,000 by 20%, subtract the $9.95 commission, and divide this value by the current ask price of $37.94, which equals 131 shares. We can then enter 131 in the quantity field. We'll select price limit, and enter a price that's a few cents above the current ask price. After verifying the order details, we'll click on Submit Order. We can then click on Place Another Trade. We'll ensure that Equity, Buy, and Canadian are all selected. We'll enter XEF next as our symbol, and hit the Tab key to populate a quote to the right. We'll multiply our total account value of $25,000 by 16%, subtract the $9.95 commission, and divide this value by the current ask price of $26.07. Which equals 153 shares. We can then enter 153 in the quantity field. We'll select price limit and enter a price that's a few cents above the current ask price. After verifying the order details, we'll click on Submit Order. We can then click on Place Another Trade. We'll ensure that Equity, Buy, and Canadian are all selected. We'll enter XEC next as our symbol and hit the Tab key to populate a quote to the right. We'll multiply our total account value of $25,000 by 4%, subtract the $9.95 commission, and divide this value by the current ask price of $20.49, which equals 48 shares. We can then enter 48 in the quantity field. We'll select price limit, and enter a price that's a few cents above the current ask price. After verifying the order details, we'll click on Submit Order. We can then click on Place Another Trade. For our final trade, we'll try to use up as much of the remaining cash as possible. There's currently $10,095.60 available. We'll ensure that Equity, Buy, and Canadian are all selected. We'll enter VAB next as our symbol and hit the Tab key to populate a quote to the right. We'll take our remaining cash balance of $10,095.60, and subtract the $9.95 commission. We'll then divide this amount by the current ask price of $25.96, which equals 388 shares. We can then enter 388 in the quantity field. We'll select price limit, and this time we'll actually enter a price that is the exact same as the current ask price. We want to use up as much of the available cash as possible while ensuring that we don't place the account into a debit position. After verifying the order details, we'll click on Submit Order. Now that our final trade has been placed, we can verify the order details. We'll hover over the trading tab at the top left of the screen, and then click on Order Status. Here we'll find that all shares from the 5 ETF purchases have been successfully filled. If you'd like to review your new portfolio holdings, hover over the My Portfolio tab at the top of the screen, and then click on Positions. Here we'll find that we now have about 40% of our portfolio in Canadian bonds, 20% in Canadian stocks, 20% in US stocks, 16% in international stocks, and 4% in emerging market stocks. If you have any questions, please feel free to send them to me by email, jbender@pwlcapital.com.